certainly not the only local district short on cash. There are a dozen asking for more of your tax dollars on May 4th, including Princeton City Schools. Should they get it? News 5's Curtis Fuller is helping you decide in tonight's Commitment 2010 report.
The need is, I mean, it's priceless for us. That when I think about, there are literally classrooms in this building where I can go and look at a wall and there's a crack where I can look outside. This is an old building and there's issues all over.
Just one example why folks here in the Princeton school system say right now is the time to build a new high school and middle school. Both buildings are about 50 years old and showing their age a bit. But in a tough economy, more taxes, it will be a tough sell. Take Harry Heckler. He's owned his home for 25 years.
I think that they should remodel rather than tear down and rebuild. I think they're missing a lot. I think they're wasting a lot of money.
New high school and a middle school with a common facility, community use in the middle, pool, auditorium, things that the community can use. But it's essentially one building. It cuts down on costs. And we're able to take advantage of tens of millions of dollars in federal stimulus money. And the big issue for us is that that money expires on December 31st.
The big question, how much will this school bond and school levy cost homeowners? A home valued at $100,000 will cost you $3.70 extra per month until 2013. Then it goes up to $12.44 a month. For seniors, $2.70 a month until 2013, $9.33 after that. And this is a long commitment.
It's over 37 years, but, you know, it's a kind of a perfect storm of conditions. We've got lower than average construction costs. That's just a supply and demand issue. And the federal stimulus money.
There's a lot of schools around here that have been in existence for 100 years, and they're still using those, and the kids are getting just as smart. I mean, it can't be that. If it's a safety feature, hey, come on, you can fix those.
The district is hoping history will be on its side. We're told only two school issues have failed in the last 50 years. As far as trying to maintain the current schools,
it's not the environment that is best for our kids.
Now, supporters say the construction project will put $180 million back into the local economy and create a lot of jobs. The school district also plans to cut $3 million, including teachers, administrators, and support staff, from its budget, even if voters approve the measure on Tuesday. If it's voted down, the budget cuts will total about $6 million.